Yesterday, 22nd April 2020, the Government of India has promulgated an ordinance by which the century-old the Epidemic Diseases Act 1897 has been amended. This has been done for two well-defined, distinct purposes. The first, the primary purpose, is to provide protection to doctors, nurses, hospitals, nursing homes. This has obviously been done with a sense of urgency in view of the recent attacks on healthcare workers that has been reported. Second, to include buses, goods vehicles, trains, aircrafts. These modes of transportation were not known in 1897 when this law was made and hence was not covered. A new section 2A has been added to include all these. The changes that have come into force, their importance, their relevance. A new section 1A has been introduced. Act of violence has been defined. And this definition is very, very broad. It even includes harassment impacting the living or working conditions of doctors and intimidations besides other violent acts. Similarly, the newly introduced Section 3.2 and Section 3.3, they prescribe punishment. And the punishment is from 3 months to 7 years. Imprisonment and fine that can be from 50,000 to 5 lakhs. Furthermore, under Section 3A1, this offense has been made cognizable and non-bailable. This should act as a big deterrent against miscreants. Certain provisions have been added to ensure serious investigations and speedy trial. Section 3A2 lays down that investigations have to be done only by an officer of the rank of inspector and above. Responsible officer, seriousness in investigations. Section 3A3 lays down that investigations have to be completed within 30 days of filing of FIR. Time limit has been set by law. No ifs, no buts. Section 3A4, it lays down that trial has to be conducted expeditiously on a day-to-day basis without any unnecessary adjournment, and every trial under these provisions has to be concluded within 18 months. Speedy conclusion and punishment of the guilty. Certain stringent provisions have also been added to make the offense serious. Section 3C, it lays down that there will be a presumption that an offense has been committed. In normal offenses, the presumption is otherwise. The accused is presumed not guilty until proven otherwise. Similarly, Section 3D lays down that culpable mental state of accused is to be presumed. In other words, intention, motive, which has to be proven by the prosecution, need not be proved here. Very easy to prove such cases. As far as punishment is concerned, Section 3A, it lays down that the court can grant additional compensation for causing hurt or grievous hurt to doctors. And in case of damage or loss to property, compensation has to be twice the amount of fair market value. Another provision lays down that the compensation granted by court can be recovered as arrears of land revenue What this really means is that instead of going to a civil court or through some other legal means, this amount need not be recovered. It can be recovered by simply approaching the tehsildar or the local revenue authority. This is easy. This is quick. On analyzing this ordinance, certain key messages emerge. First, this amendment, the new law, is only for the purpose of this pandemic. Let this be absolutely clear. Once the Epidemic Diseases Act is revoked, these provisions will have no effect. Furthermore, this is an ordinance and hence its life is not more than 6 months. If at all it has to be extended beyond that period, it will again have to be promulgated. Second, this ordinance will provide the much needed legal support which was required by doctors and hospitals against violence. In fact, it is one of the toughest penal laws of the country. Third, let us compliment the government for bringing out this ordinance in such a short period, and that too in such a situation, a pandemic. Lastly, this ordinance will be of great help to doctors in their long pending demands for a national law on violence against doctors and hospitals. Whenever such a law is made, a permanent one, it will be very tough for the government of the day to dilute these strict provisions. Many doctors have questioned why a permanent law was not made on this subject. And the answer is, it could not have been made in such a hurry. A permanent law on such an important subject covering the entire nation has to be discussed, debated, and then the parliament has to pass it. A beginning has at least been made, and that too in the right direction. Let us all accept it. The Honorable Prime Minister has commended doctors for working tirelessly and selflessly in this pandemic. A new law, very strict, has been brought into existence so swiftly. Let us all welcome it and put our energies in meeting the challenges that this pandemic poses to our society, our nation, and to mankind. Thank you.